This video demonstrates how to easily navigate through various parts of a complex model. Let's consider an example model containing two sections, logic and animation. The logic part is outside the default visible area marked by the blue rectangle. While you can pan the canvas manually to reach a certain area, it's much more convenient to use View Areas. Let's drag the View Area element from the presentation palette to the main diagram. We'll position it in the top left corner of the logic section. Set its name to View Logic and the title to Logic. View Area defines a virtual screen displaying a specific part of the model canvas. We'll leave the default top left value of the Align To property. It will make the View Area's anchor define the virtual screen's top left corner. Let's run the model. Now, you can switch to the model logic by opening the Navigate to View Area menu and selecting Logic, which is the title of our view area. You can go back to the animation section by either using the same toolbar button or right-clicking inside the model window and selecting View Area Origin. Origin means the default view area marked with the blue rectangle. Now we will simplify navigation by creating an interactive ribbon. Drag the rectangle element from the presentation palette onto the main diagram. Adjust the rectangle position and size to locate it above the animation section and make it span across the visible area. Set its fill color to blue and line color to no color. Add the text element to display the name of the model and put it over the rectangle. Set its text to model and adjust its font size and color. Now, we'll duplicate this text element and set its text to logic. This element will act as a clickable link taking us to the logic section during the model execution. Type viewlogic.navigateTo in the text's onClick action. To avoid possible syntax errors, press Ctrl plus space to open the code completion window. Select the name of the view area and then the function name from the list. ViewLogic is the name of the view area that we created. We call its NavigateTo function to switch to this area during the model run. To implement switching to the animation section, we need to duplicate the interactive text element. We'll set text to animation and provide the following onClick action. Underscore origin underscore VA dot navigate to. Follow the syntax strictly. Mind the two underscore symbols and the capital VA letters. Origin VA is the reference to the origin view area. To highlight the area we're currently in, add a rectangle, place it over the animation text, and make it light blue. This rectangle appears on the top of the other elements, and we need to adjust its Z order. We move the rectangle to the lowest level by clicking Send to Back, and then we bring it forward. As a result, it's positioned in between our background rectangle and text elements. Let's display model date and time by adding an extra text element. Since it doesn't require any onClick actions, we can simply reuse the model text element. We type in date as the text value, which will be displayed during the model design time. Then we switch the field to dynamic value and provide the date function call there. Our navigation bar is ready, and we can copy it to the logic section. Now we need to move and resize the rectangle, highlighting our location in the model. Since navigation in our model is now handled by the navigation ribbon, we'll go to the simulation experiment properties and disable manual panning and zoom. Let's run the model and navigate within it. You can see the model name and current model time. On clicking Logic, you'll be taken to the Logic section. Click Animation to get back to the Animation section. Voila! This technique will inevitably improve your model usability and perception. Thanks for watching. Leave your ideas for the upcoming videos in the comments below.